1879, An Jung-gun was born in Haeju, Hwanghae Province, situated at the 38th parallel. Korea's provisional government president Kim Gu describes An Jung-gun as being a smart and courageous young man after meeting him in Cheonggye-dong. Thirty-one years later, An Jung-gun dies on the 38th parallel. But this time, it's in China's Lushun prison and not his hometown. And he hasn't been able to return home for 100 years. We look into the last moments of An Jung-gun's life and seek his remains at the once tightly sealed 38th parallel. Now, we'll open the doors to retell his story once more. Years ago, in Sacramento, USA, we met up with the grandson of An Jung-gun. A doctor of internal medicine, he was preparing a book on his grandfather. At almost 70 years of age, he seemed to long for his grandfather very much, almost religiously.
You know, this is my, you know, don't ever say he's dead, he's not, you know.
Oh.
Hey, look, look. Well, spirit is the only way, of expressing he's alive. That's the only way people seem to understand. Physically, everybody thinks he's dead. So, you know, my expression of saying he's alive. And they can, it's hard for them to say, you know, killed spirit. That's why I use the word spirit. You know.
Mr. An Ung-ho, who sees his grandfather as a role model, is currently fighting an illness. 10 years later, we met up with An Ung-ho's son, An Jung-gun's great-grandson. 100 years have passed since the death of An Jung-gun.
These are notes that were made.
What the family members want more than anything else is to reclaim the remains of An Jung-gun.
Is actually grandfather.
My father believes that the best place to bury the remains of An Jung-gun is right along the 38th parallel between North and South Korea, because our family believes there is only one Korea. An Jung-gun's dream was for one Korea. And it's only fitting that the remains be buried on that 38th parallel. In doing so, both the North and South Koreans would bow to An Jung-gun, and in doing so, they would be bowing to each other.
There is yet another place that eagerly awaits An's remains. Seoul's Hyochang Park. Next to the tombs of independence fighters like Baek Jong-gi, Yoon Bong-gil, and Lee Bong-chan, lies a grave without a tombstone. The tomb has been reserved for An Jung-gun, but his remains have yet to make it there. The president of Korea's provisional government, Kim Gu, created the grave. After Korea's independence, Kim Gu suggested a joint venture to the North Korean leader Kim Il-sung for the two Koreas to look for An Jung-gun's remains in Lushan prison where he died. But this was never realized.
그분을 위해서 우리 모셔가도록 좀 중국 정부에 안내를 해서 좀 모셔가도록 해달라. 그러니까 그것도 역시 그것도 이제 외국이고 그 중국이고 우리하고 가깝고 다 우방이지만 그 제 마음대로 안 됩니다. 그때는 이제 자기네들 정부술이 전이거든요. 인민위원회 때. 그러니까 그것도 역시 앞으로 미루는 게 좋겠습니다. 우리 이번에 어시니까 통일 문제나 언론을 하시고 하면 그런 거 다 나중에 뭐 문제가 될 거 없습니다. 이렇게 거절을 했어요.
And for the next 50 years, people would forget about An's final moments. Memorial Hall in Japan houses a bullet that was shot by An Jung-gun in Harbin. This is the very bullet that was shot at Ito Hirobumi, the resident general of Korea, and his men. October 26th, 1909. Ito Hirobumi had met with Russian Finance Minister Kokopetev for a meeting on board a train before being received by honor guards at Harbin Station. Just then, An Jung-gun, who had been waiting among the crowd, aims his gun at Ito Hirobumi, who had stepped out of the train. An Jung-gun's bullet killed Ito Hirobumi, and An was arrested on site. An Jung-gun tried to inform the world of Korea's rightful independence. The world's media organizations immediately reported on the death of Japan's imperialistic leader.
안중근 의거가 갖는 첫 번째 의미는 당시 대한제국이 무기력하게 일본 침략을 맞이해서 아무런 조치를 하지도 못할 때 안중근 의사가 대한국 의병 중장의 자격으로 적장 2등 방문을 포살하면서 독립전쟁을 실질적으로 선포했다고 하는 그런 점에서 아마 의미를 찾을 수 있을 것 같습니다.
After the assassination, An Jung-gun was taken to China's Lushan prison. Lushan, formerly Russian territory, had been under Japanese rule for 40 years since 1905 after the Russo-Japanese War. The prison is now an important Chinese military base, currently restricted to foreign visitors. An Jung-gun spent his last 5 months in this prison. Although Lushan prison still remains today, transformed into a history museum, it was very difficult to follow An Jung-gun's trail. And the documents no longer existed. On August 15th, 1945, upon surrender, Japanese prison guards at Lushan prison burnt all the documents that were relevant to the prison. With the aid of old maps, official documents, and eyewitness testimonies, the prison was recreated in each period. During the 50 years following An Jung-gun's imprisonment in 1910, the prison has undergone several major reconstruction jobs that has altered its appearance. It's easy to see that the prison looks very different now compared to how it looked in 1910. The sites in the compound marked relevant to An Jung-gun lacked sufficient evidence to support the claims. The location of An Jung-gun's supposed single cell was based mostly on speculation that he was an important prisoner and should have been well secured by the chief prison guard.
그 지금 그 안중근 사의 반방으로 지금 그 반판이 붙은 곳은 그 1941년 통항하기 직전에 감옥에서 그 사환 심부름하던 사람이 있었습니다. 그 사람이 증언에 하면 이곳이 간수부장의 그 방이다. 문제는 이 간수부장의 방이가 1945년 전 직전, 그러니까 35년 전에 역시 간수부장의 방이었겠는가 하는 것은 아직 고정이 안 됐습니다.
After An Jung-gun was locked up, the Japanese government moved swiftly. Even before the public hearing began in court, a war message ordered his execution. An Jung-gun's crime is very severe and crude and must be given a harsh sentence. In a secret reply, the government official dispatched from Japan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs to Lushun stated that An Jung-gun would be executed. If An Jung-gun is sentenced to life imprisonment, I'll make sure that he gets the death penalty in a higher court. As you can see, An Jung-gun's execution was predetermined. An Jung-gun remained composed in his cold prison cell, where he started to write, one letter at a time. He wrote that giving up one's body in times of despair was the duty of a soldier. This is Japan's Kochi Prefecture. Most of the Japanese judges that handled An's case were from this region. Gumong, a former councilman of Kochi, has carried out research on An Jung-gun for 20 years. He invited us to the home of a war journalist who covered the trial. Mr. Komatsu takes out the belongings of his uncle. In 1910, his uncle had covered the trials carried out in the Lushun courts. And he left detailed illustrations of the hearing procedures. An Jung-gun's trial garnered international attention. Public opinion claimed it was unfair to have the trial carried out in Lushun. Some Japanese lawyers claimed An Jung-gun's innocence.
やっぱり国を救うための、政治的な動機を持った、自分自身の恨みに、個人的な恨みによるものではないということですよね。だから国士として、国事犯としてやっぱり扱うべきだという考えだったんじゃないでしょうか。弁護の中で取り上げて、案を極刑に処すべきではないと。
At the Seoul Museum of History, works of An's calligraphy art are being stored. It was donated by a descendant of a Japanese prosecutor. An himself signed and presented the work to Yasuoka, the prosecutor. We decided to pay Yasuoka's family members a visit in Tokyo. Ms. Yoshi is Yasuoka's daughter-in-law. She had heard a great deal about Anjungun through her father-in-law. Prosecutor Yasuoka met Anjungun in Lushun Prison and respected him his entire life. On February 7, 1910, Anjungun's trial began. We were able to go inside the very court as it was reconstructed. The trial was presided over by prosecutors, judges, and lawyers designated by Japan. During the six hearings, Anjungun announced 15 criminal charges against Ito. He stated that Ito assassinated Empress Myeongseong, dethroned the emperor, and forced the Ulsa Treaty of 1905.
제국주의 법정이 꼼짝 못하고 피고의 신분인 안사에게 제국주의가 거꾸로 심판을 당하는 그런 재판이 된 것입니다. 영국의 더 그래픽 타임스에서는 그 재판 광경을 보고 나서 마지막으로 평했습니다. 30세 젊은 청년 안중근이 그 시대의 제국주의의 가장 실세인 이등박문을 한낱 파렴치한 독재자로 전락시키고 청년 안중근은 재판의 승리자로서 월계관을 쓰고 당당히 법정을 나섰다고 하는 그런 평가를 내렸어요.
At the court, Anjungun stated the justification of the independence movement as well as the paradox of imperialism. He also suggested peace in Asia. Anjungun conceptualized unions of states that would stop disputes and promote the independence of each nation. Through An's unfinished written work on peace in East Asia and his last testament, we can understand him as a great thinker.
This event was for the peace of East Asia. I hope that Japanese officials will understand my wishes and cooperate with each other for peace in East Asia.
囚われの身で非常に短い時間の中で、その極めてリアルな当時の国際政治、アジアの、つまり日中韓、この三国の厳しいその戦いや緊張関係の中で、どのようにしたらその平和が可能になるかということをですね、
And on February 14, 1910, the Lushun District Court sentenced An Jung-gun to death. And 40 days later, An dies on the execution grounds. We decided to seek out the very place where Mr. An took his last breath. Through excavation efforts, Lushun Prison has preserved the gallows and remains of those who were executed. But this execution ground was used after the 1930s. So where did Mr. An meet death in 1910? The first presumed location is the execution grounds used by the Russians until 1905. Execution grounds are usually situated at the end of a building. Japan took over Lushun Prison and built extensions in 1907. If the annex building wasn't finished by 1910, there's a possibility Mr. An was executed here. The Russian grounds were singled out because of its relevance in handling the corpse. According to the executioner's report, An's body was moved to the lecture room after the execution. From the Russian grounds, the lecture room is situated in the same building along the same line. We decided to take a closer look at the execution grounds. We went into the Russian execution site, which is relatively unknown to the rest of the world. Did An Jung-gun close his eyes for the last time in this dark and narrow space? But in a contributing article by An's translator, we found discrepancies between the Russian execution grounds and the place described to be An's execution grounds. The steps were different. An Jung-gun had walked slowly up 7 steps. But in the Russian site, there were 13 steps in all. If this wasn't the spot, it was highly likely that An Jung-gun was executed in the execution site built in 1907. As the war continued, Japanese officials threw Chinese and Korean independence fighters into Lushun Prison. Therefore, the size of the prison continued to increase. Extension work was carried out in the 1920s and 30s. And due to the changes, it was hard to find traces of the execution grounds from the 1910s. But a clue was found in an unlikely place. It was from a map made in the 1910s. This sketch was drawn for the purpose of constructing a water pipeline, but it included the execution grounds of the prison. This building, made of cement instead of the typical red bricks, hadn't caught anyone's attention in the past. But inside, red bricks were visible from in between the crumbling walls. The interior was totally empty, indicating that perhaps it had once had a different purpose. But on the ceiling were remnants of the execution apparatus.
그 건물이 우리는 그 전에는 그 건물에 대해서 전혀 주시하지 않았습니다. 그런데 그 건물이 이렇게 1층 슬랍 저기 슬레이트로 되어 있고 그 위에 공기통 구멍처럼 높게 우리 서대문 용서에도 그렇게 높게 공기통 구멍이 있습니다. 그 공기통 구멍이 높게 되어 있어 가지고 거기에 이렇게 석가래 처럼 되어 있습니다. 그래서 그 석가래 높이에서 1층 땅까지 높이는 충분히 그 사형이 교수형이 집행될 만한 높이였습니다. 그래서 사다리를 구해 가지고 그 석가래 위에 있는 나무를 가서 확인해 봤더니 슬킨 자국이 있었어요.
People say that this is the most likely place that Mr. An Jung-gun died. An headed for the execution site, dressed in white clothing that his mother had made for him. On March 26, 1910, at 10 in the morning, 31-year-old An Jung-gun's life came to an end. Would he be able to return home now that he is dead? All we have are records stating that he was buried in the prison graveyard. There is no other indication about his remains. Many sites had been presumed to be the burial location of An Jung-gun. After Japan lost the war, Lu Xun was returned to China. But An Jung-gun was still fast asleep under the Lu Xun sky, and 100 years have passed. But no one knows exactly where he is buried. A Japanese woman offered a glimmer of hope. Her name was Imai Husako. She handed over two photographs to Choi So-myun, director of the International Korean Research Institute. It was a photograph of Lu Xun prison circa 1911. In the photo, an arrow was marked near the mountains. She said, that grave belonged to An Jung-gun. And there was another photograph of the prison that was taken from behind.
내가 여섯 년 무서워. 소장 딸이라고. 근데 내가 그 안 죽은 재형날래 거기 있었다고. 몇 살 때 있어? 8살 때 내가 6살 때 안 죽은 재형 받았다고. 근데 어느 날 이제 그 아버지가 돌아오더니 내일은 절대로 마당에 나가지 말고 저녁까지 집에 있어라. 나가면 안 된다. 그래서 제 어머니하고 얘기를 하는데 아까운 놈 하나 죽인다고. 그놈이 안 죽는 놈이야.
The two photographs established the grounds for the excavation of An's remains. China agreed to allow the excavation of An Junggun's remains to take place in Lushun if the two Koreas cooperated and provided specific evidence. North and South Korean officials held talks in cooperation on the excavation.
여기서 보고 저기서 보고 그러면은 그렇다면 후문에 저 진짜 후문으로 갔을 때 저 후문 뒤에 무슨 그 묘지들이 있는지 가보셨으니까 네, 난 그거 하나 의문입니다. 그게 뭐 지금 그 후문 상태가 후문 뒷산 상태가 어디든지 지금
후문을 통해서 뒷산에 묻었다는데 여기 아직 후문 뒤냐 했더니 그 사람이 우리가 후문에서 나갔다 그럼 가보자 갔더니 이 문을 가리킨단 말이에요. 이건 연문이지. 연문의 옆산이지. 후문의 후산이 아니지 않느냐. 그 후문을 찾아라. 거기 갔던 사람들이 몇 사람 벗어 보니까 바로 여기 문을 메꾼 자리가 나왔습니다.
North and South Korea held three meetings before sending a joint investigative committee to Lushun in 2006. The first thing the committee did was to check the rear door. Ms. Husako had testified that An Junggun's remains were buried in the mountains beyond the rear door of the prison. The committee confirmed the location of the former rear exit and tracked down the location of the grave in the photograph. 2 years later, the Korean task force started the excavation of An Junggun's remains in Lushun with the cooperation of Chinese officials. The door on the 38th parallel was finally opening after 100 years. Would Mr. An Junggun make it back to his home country? In March 2008, an excavation committee arrived in Lushun to take his remains back to Korea. It took fellow Koreans many decades to come back for Mr. An Junggun's remains. The prison surroundings looked very different from the photograph. The committee had just two photographs to work with. The first thing to be determined was where the photograph was taken. This, however, was impossible because the nearby landscape had completely changed. The remaining ridgeline of the mountain was measured in detail. To get the same effects as on the photograph, the same type of camera was used to compare the geographical features of the area and the one in the photograph. As a result, the committee was able to find a spot that was identical to the mark in the photograph. In addition, they were able to check the spot of the mountain burial by connecting the rooftops and the mountain ridges.
형무소의 감옥 지붕이라든지 그 다음에 멀리 보이는 그 산의 지형들이 등고선 등이 이제 변하지가 않았기 때문에 그걸 이용해서 당시에 사용됐던 그 카메라를 사용을 해서 그 사진이 찍힌 그 지점을 저희가 찾고자 노력을 했습니다. 그래서 그 지점을 찾으면은 이제 그 지점이 감옥소 묘지다 이렇게 저희가 추정을 했죠.
The presumed burial site was located at the rear of the prison. It was located near the southeastern foot of the mountain. The committee had 20 days to excavate. The area of land to be excavated was 5,000 square meters. The topography of the region had changed greatly. There were traces of the land having been repeatedly used for farming. People started to feel insecure that perhaps Mr. An Junggun's remains would not be intact. the third day of the excavation, traces of the former prison began to resurface. The layout was built with red bricks, and the floor was covered with cement. It's presumed to be the food storage room. Extensive excavation was carried out on the very spot marked on the photograph. Features of the former prison soon became visible. This is a Russian-made brick used in the early 1900s. Even some plates used by inmates were dug up. The excavation committee was digging back in time to Anjungun's era. On the seventh day, people began to bustle about. A wooden structure was found in the soil. Perhaps it was a coffin. A far cry from the circular coffins of all other prisoners, it's been known that Anjungun had been buried in a wooden coffin.
저희가 발굴을 하던 중에 이제 어느 날 그 발굴한 지 3, 4일 지나고 나서 그 나무가 투토되기 시작을 했습니다. 흔적이 보였어요. 그래서 저희는 전부 다 그 발굴단이 긴장을 했죠. 아, 이게 혹시 그 그때 사용됐던 그런 침묵의 일부분이 아닐까. 그래서 이제 전부 다 긴장들을 하고 열심히 발굴 작업을 했는데 발굴을 하면 날아가면 날아갈수록 보니까 그건 그 관의 그 부재가 아니라 그 당시에 기둥을 파서 묻었던 기둥의 흔적이었습니다.
Unfortunately, the committee was unable to find the remains of Anjungun. It was evident that soil had been dug up many times after the 1910s. In addition, only household waste was found in this place.
1916년, 18년, 23년에 걸쳐서 그 여순 형무소가 증축이 됩니다. 증축이 되면서 증축에 필요한 그 벽돌의 재료, 그 재료가 안의사가 묻혀 있었던 그 지역으로의 흙을 갖다 퍼다가 그 벽돌을 만든 걸로 저희가 추정을 하고 있습니다. 그래서 안의사 묘가 그 자리에 남아있지 못하고 16년, 18년, 23년 사이에 그쯤에 대해서 손상이 되지 않았나 그렇게 생각을 하고 있습니다.
It was a difficult task on foreign soil. There was much damage done during the last 100 years, and much of it has disappeared. The committee had no choice but to rebury the soil without the remains of Mr. An. It took such a long time to get here. Why did Anjungun have to disappear without a trace? Our producers found a secret document in Japan concerning the remains of Anjungun. Japan had been worried that Anjungun's grave would be considered a sanctuary. Koreans planned to take the corpse of Anjungun and have him buried in Harbin. They will erect a memorial and respect him as a national hero. If we are not cautious when An's remains are handed over, the above mentioned will be realized. Therefore, we must be careful.
이게 안중근이가 죽은 다음에 그 유해가 할빈에 오면은 거기 안중근 묘가 만들어진다면 한국 독립운동의 메카 중심처럼 될 거다. 그렇게 되면 우리 할빈 총영사관이 견딜 수가 없게 된다. 그는 제발 이 할빈의 그 유해가 오지 않도록 좀 해달라.
Japanese prison law at the time stated that the remains of the deceased may be transferred to family. But this clause did not apply to An Jung-un. Japan did not hand over An's remains to his two brothers. And 100 years of silence has passed.
遺体を発掘が進んでないとまた見えないということは私も知っています。なかなかこのことに対しては日本に非常に大きな責任があると思いますけども。
그때 마시 일본이 어떤 그 법에 따라서 안중근사 유해를 가족한테 돌려줬다면 지금 같은 우리 그 유해 발굴의 힘든 어려움은 없었을 거라고 생각합니다.
안중근's remains have disappeared without a trace. But his spirit will not be forgotten. Dairinji is located in Japan's Miyagi Prefecture. In this temple, situated in a small Japanese village, a ceremony is held every year in honor of Anjungun. The ceremony has continued for 30 years. As long as there are people who respect An's philosophy and values, the ceremony is bound to continue in the future.
대한민국 안중근 기시대의 나라빈이
東洋平和を掲げて取り組んでいるその姿にすごいなと思っておりますし、また人を非常に大事にしてくれる方でありますし、それから人を導いてくれる そういうすごい包容力のある感じでありますので、素晴らしい方だなと思っております。Bungakuza
is a theater troupe based in central Tokyo, Japan. The life story of a 31-year-old Korean army soldier who killed a Japanese imperial leader only to be executed 100 years ago is still performed on stage today.
つまりあなたが義兵に参加したのも伊藤校を暗殺したのも全て神の意志、神の意志だということです。言葉で表現できるものではありません。理屈だとか論理だとかそういったものを超越した何か大きなもの。やはり、どこか国を 背負っている、そして自分のやってることに信念を持っている人物という、そういう人ならではの、輝きっていうんですかね、揺るぎないところというものが、この台本にも書かれていて、そこにどこか心惹かれる、やっぱりそれが自分にも跳ね返ってくるというところが、僕自身ありましたし、実際歴史の中でも、 日本人の監獄にいる連中が心を通わせていったっていうふうに、事実として残ってるんですけれども、やはり立派な人間だったんだと思いますね。Mr.
An's descendants wanted nothing more than to have his remains buried at the 38th parallel, the line of demarcation between North and South Korea.
This is soil from Yeosun Prison in China.
The soil from Lushun has become a part of An's family.
I think that great-grandfather had his dream of a unified Asia. It was not realized while he was alive. I think it's only fitting that now in his death, that finally he's able to unite the Asian countries to working together to find his remains. I think it's very fitting, but I think more must be done if we're ever to be unified.
100 years after gunshots were fired in Harbin, we have yet to find the remains of An Jung-gun. But his spirit remains alive in the Korean Peninsula, in China, in Japan, and even in the United States of America.